everyone, Deck Stimulator bringing you some more naval action. Today we've got a battle on Rough Sea, which is the standard PvP matchup. I'm in my snow and working with a Constitution and two Trincomalee against a Victory and a Surprise. This should be a very, very interesting matchup. So we'll be looking to essentially stern camp Victory, as it is a very heavy class of ship. However, essentially that's what we're all going to be doing. So it's very important that I don't get in the way of the ships that can actually do some proper damage. I'm going to be switching up to chain shot and just going to work on its sails and masts. I've actually started very, very close together, which I feel... I assume that the starting positions that give some variety to the way that the games go, because we're practically on top of one another here. I'm going to have to catch the wind, otherwise I'm going to slow down far too much. I don't really want to take a shot until my ship's out of the way, so I don't risk just going straight through their sail and tearing into my ally. Yep, did nothing because he was fortunately switched to battle sail. I'm going to hope that the waves are going to essentially protect me here. Ooh, yeah, they did a damn good job actually. Gonna lie. Switching over to survival. And gonna get repairs underway because I got leaks everywhere. Got a few little hits off against Karu there. Nothing to write home about. Swells. Going to play an absolute havoc with my ability to navigate around this map. My primary concern is just staying out of his gun's range. That was good. He shot high. Refusely fire off my cannonades. Might have gone through, but probably not. I really enjoy playing in the rough weather. I think it adds a great element to the game. but is very, very much absent in the regular calm seas. Mainly because it gives me a chance. I'm nowhere near as skillful as many of the people playing this, to be fair, and I need that element of randomness to match up. As I'm still taking my time to learn the ships and get better at actually controlling them, using my sails, maneuvering myself properly. Class ship. We'll see how it goes. Be careful not to present a really easy target, but I probably will anyway. Swells, this means he won't actually be able to do much, if anything, to me. It appears he's not going to take the shot. So my caution was unfounded. I'm going to switch up to double shot on the left hand side because I've done a fair way of damage to the sails. Shooting high, sending a double shot through the sails rigging. And then I should sweep him behind him. Switch my crew back to survival as I'm taking on some water, and I don't want any unexpected damage to lead me to sink too rapidly. Now, one of the things to take notice as well is, due to the location of the servers, I actually have a very high ping, and it does occasionally cause me to miss what's going on. So I won't know if someone shot me or not, sometimes I'll just have a fair whack of damage. It hasn't been too obvious in the videos, because surprisingly the lag actually doesn't have a huge impact on my performance in the game. I hope it doesn't have too much of an impact on people's performance against me. Now, if anyone has played against me, and it has, do let me know. Because I'd like to take it into account in how lucky I am, basically. Sailing, first opportunity. I'm gonna aim as high as possible. One or two small hits against Karu. I'm not too disappointed at that. Swing the ship about. Guys with guns, fixing the sails. Not so much because I called the shot there, but because he's turning and I don't really want to get cut off by him. And that is the effect that the waves can have, unfortunately. That might not be able to do anything to Karu, who's actually had to use at least one repair kit on his sails. Because at one point he was down to 77. Okay, just waiting. That should... tiny little tickling impact on Uptight Kraken. He may just run me over here, if I'm not careful. In fact... I believe I've just gotten out of his way. Subjective to the fact that, you know, he's going to have an entire set of guns impact on me. Oh no, I'm lucky because, of course, Sea Daddy was there. He would much rather target Sea Daddy than myself. And my guys in survival mode as I've got some water coming in. So I'm going to slow myself down. Barely scratch his ship with my double shot. He's doing a little whack of damage to me. Fire off the little cannonades in the front of my ship. The rear of my ship. All I'm trying to do is just stay ahead of him, because if he gets side on with me, he will just sink me. hiding behind the swell. Might be lucky. Yes. Pick up my sails again. Yep, only a few minutes. That was lucky and lucky on my part. Was my intention, and see. After I get another set of shots off against him, I'm going to switch up my left side to chain shot, because I would like to start working on his sails. Chases there. Not that they will do anything, because I think they're only 12 cannonades. Let's just have a look. Yeah, just little cannonades. Focusing on survival at the moment. Making sure the ship doesn't flood. It has indicated that they want to board the ship. They'll be massively outnumbered. Can't see it going particularly well for them. At least to my knowledge, you can't stack up boarding, so you can't have two ships boarding one ship. Though, once again, my knowledge is really limited in this game. I'll probably spend some time on the forums over the next week and just some information about how it actually works. In general game mechanics exclusively, of course. Alright. Just waiting to get a shot off here. Tobacco Spit is intent on boarding him. Whether he'll be able to or not is another matter. Trying to do stuff in this weather would be absolutely nightmarish, to say the least. try and get in and get some shots off on that stern. All the armor's been removed from it. I'm not too sure how many repair kits Uptime Crackers used. Well, at least he's enjoying himself. Once again, modelling saves me. My ship doesn't get caught up in his mast. This doesn't have any significant issue. Get the wind here, which will be problematic for our ships. Looks like the arena has begun to shrink. The battle would just come to the edge without us realizing it, without me realizing it at any rate. It's actually surprising how good an amount of time 5 minutes is to get back in, depending on how desperate you are, or how your manoeuvring's going, it's a decent amount of time, but without being too much. Especially in situations like this. Curious if he's used any repair kits. Intentionally this time, just if he ends up shooting higher, I don't want to completely was fortunate. I can probably maintain myself with survival mode. See on the swell. The wind build up a little bit of speed, slot onto the tail of Sea Daddy here, and just follow him. There is a slight delay between when you fire and when your crew actually shoots. I need to take that into account more often. Just slowing right down so once again I can let Sea Daddy pass me. As much as I do want to get in there, it's better leaving the larger ships to have the prime positions. Well, there is a light PvP mode where you don't get the larger ships. The fact that you can often have such disparate kind of levels or classes of ship together is interesting, to say the least. And it certainly has an impact on the way the games go. Because there's not really any other conditions other than sink the opponent's ships. There's not really any sort of variety to it. If the game does develop an open world environment, you could bet that if I was a snow and I came across a homily or you know, in a victory, I'd not be sticking around to try and fight it. I would be legging it as best I could. I mean, naturally, they could probably catch me, and there it would actually my objective, changing up the start of the play, being just trying desperately to escape big ships. I mean, naturally I would support other big ships taking them, but solo, not so much. And that's it, they've sunk it. Well done to those large ships, happy to have helped out a little bit there. And thank you very much for watching. This has been Death Stimulator. If you did enjoy the video, please consider liking, commenting, favouriting, or subscribing, as your support means the world to me. And I'll see you next time.